Sad for all the students who wanted a bright future. They could as well have taken to kidnapping themselves so that they can make quick money. But they opted to go to school. And look at what our government has done to them. As a person myself who has been kidnapped before by the Nigerian government, I know what it means to be in captivity. I know what it means to have zero expectation for when you will leave, when you rejoin your family, and all the anxiety that goes with it. I'm not here to appeal to the government. Don't get me wrong. The government has failed. The Nigerian government has failed the Nigerian people. It is up to the Nigerian people to decide how long they want to continue to tolerate this failure. It is up to you. And it doesn't matter. Don't be afraid of security agents. They themselves have failed. Soldiers are getting kidnapped.
True.
Colonels, they go and pay ransom. A DSS guy was kidnapped. They paid ransom and they killed him after that. Nothing happened. But the only thing the DSS can tell you is that if you are speaking out at this time, they will come after you. But they cannot come after kidnappers. They can't come after bandits. They can't come after the terrorists, including those who are in government. They can't go after them, but they are very happy to go after you if you speak your mind. Nigeria is the only country in the world where people are beaten up and roughened up, and they are not allowed to cry. They are not allowed to express sadness. I was told by the parents when they arrived here that they were told not to protest, that they should not even speak to the press because somebody is doing something about their plight. Nobody is doing anything about your plight. They are not interested. The federal government does not care about you. The Kaduna State governor does not care about you. I heard him saying that he will never negotiate with terrorists. I said, who asked you to negotiate with terrorists? Same Nasiru who was blaming Jonathan for not negotiating with Boko Haram people when they kidnapped Chibok girls. Suddenly, has realized that they can't negotiate with terrorists. The reason they don't negotiate with terrorists is because the government itself is a terroristic government.
Yes. Yes.
That is why. Otherwise, they know how to negotiate with terrorists.
They know where they
in fact,
now.
The most prolific negotiator with terrorists lives in Kaduna. What is his name? Gumi. So they could have just gone to Gumi's house. Please help us talk to your brothers.
Yeah.
Let them release our children. But they are not interested. They love it when you are suffering. They love it when there's pain. They love it when there's blood and there's tears flowing in the land. They doesn't know how to negotiate with terrorists. There was a time in this country that Boko Haram appointed Buhari to be their negotiator. If he can be trusted enough by Boko Haram, he should trust himself enough to also lead negotiations to release their FACA students and the Griffith students. We must not live through the nightmare of hearing that these children have died in captivity. May it never happen to anyone of us. And may it not happen to those Griffith kids who have been given to this deadline. May it never happen that they will be killed. And let's use this opportunity to talk to whomever is holding them, that you are holding innocent people. Yes, you are holding innocent children of poor people like you. Change your mind. Change your mind. You know who your enemies are. The students of the School of Forestry in Apaka, they are not your enemies. The leaders who turned you to kidnappers and terrorists and bandits, you know them. Go and hold them to account. Stop going after soft targets. Don't get me wrong. I am not saying that they should go after to kill anybody. I'm not saying that all of us should come together. Anybody that has been cheated, who has a grouse against the system, should come together and fight the system. And stop this excuse that, well, the reason we are kidnapping is because we are poor. The people you are kidnapped to are poor. The reason we are kidnapping is because we didn't go to school. The people you are kidnapping to are barely going to school.